not do that. So what do we do? What is taqwa? Taqwa means if he says this is not good for you, believe him. Don't disobey him. I'll give you one example. Intergender relations, relationships between boys and girls. I know it is very hard to resist having a relationship, a friendship with the opposite gender. It's very hard before the age of marriage. But it's not impossible. It's not impossible. One person asked me the other day, Sayyid, what's wrong for me? She was a female. What's wrong for me if I can have honest friendship with my colleague, with my friend in the school? I can go out with him to have some cappuccino, you know, some coffee, some drink. And we just chat over a few things. And I said to him, if you guarantee 100% that the relationship is going to be honest, then there is nothing wrong with it. But you cannot guarantee that. Because the moment you go with him on the first trip, on the first date, you're going to be accompanied by whom? Huh? Satan is going to say, me, don't leave me alone. You have to buy a third ticket for him to join you. If you are going to a restaurant, you have to reserve three seats. You and your girlfriend and the Satan. He has to be there. And this is not just me. This is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. ما اختلا أجنبيان إلا وكان الشيطان ثالثهما ولا يتركهما حتى يوردهما الردى. Once two people who are not halal with each other, they are not a husband and wife. Two strangers, أجنبي means two strangers, they are not mahram. They get together privately. Satan is going to join them immediately, and he would never leave them until he forced them to commit fornication. So be very careful. Don't tell me this is an honest friendship. There is nothing called honest friendship. Do you want to have an honest friendship? Wait until you get married and make your wife your true friend. Let her be your friend. Because if you do this, if you insist on going on dates, then you have to pay the price later on. Every action, every emotional action that you do, every emotional gesture, every emotional relationship that you have, it has a price. It has some repercussions later on. Sometimes you say, it's honest, I go with her for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, let's have some fun. And then we go back to our families. We go back to our bases safe. Safe and sound. This is not the truth. You have heart, you have mind, you have eyes, you have feelings. You are not a piece of material. You're going to interact with that person. And if it doesn't work, good. Then it is going to have repercussion. It's going to have some setback on your feelings, your psyche, your nafs, your life. You're going to pay the price. You're going to pay the price. Some of these relationships, failed relationships, result in depression. You may not notice it. Some of them may be not very obvious depression, but some emotional wound and injuries. So do not injure your spirit. Make yourself strong. These injuries are going to weaken you. When do you feel them? Maybe you don't feel them at the age of 20 or 30 or 40. You're going to feel them later on in your life. Why many people have anxiety? He's worried. He's worried about doing anything. You see him before, nothing wrong with him. All of a sudden, he's very worried. He's anxious. He's in a state of fear. Because maybe he did something 20 years ago. This is the result of a failed relationship, maybe 20, maybe 30 years before. He's paying the price now. So my friends, make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala your good friend. Obey Him. Obey Him. Do not disobey Allah. If you are seeking success in this life, if you are seeking perpetual smile on your face, not perpetual sadness, perpetual smile and happiness and joy inside you, the heart, you have to strengthen this relationship with Him. With Him.